Thank you, Roger. Tonight's starting goaltenders are brought to you by Intact Insurance Company. You're back for the Los Angeles Kings, 1-0 on the season. They'll give the nod to 22-year-old first-round pick of 06, Jonathan Bernier. In three NHL appearances last year, he was 3-0 with a .957 save percentage. And Mika Kiprusoff, in his second consecutive game to open the season, as you would expect, he was 3-1 against the LA Kings last season with a .151 goals against average and a .940 save percentage. A matter of fact, Charlie, the Flames, in those three wins and in the entire four-game season set, only allowed four total goals at home in six period against the Kings.
Well, definitely was a very close checking tight series between these two clubs last year.
And the home opener underway. Alex Tanguay with Jerome McGinley and Olli Jokinen. Giordano and Bomeister on defense against the Kings' top unit of Anze Kopitar, Ryan Smith, and Captain Dustin Brown. Lineups brought to you by Moore's Clothing for Men. Well-made, well-priced, well-dressed. Hagman pokes it in. Drew Doughty brings it towards Brown as Rennie Bork throws a big hit on the young blue liner. Kopitar carries in his shot and a test for Mika Kiprusoff in the game's opening moment. Brendan Morrison left it behind the net. Brad Richardson on the forecheck with Justin Williams, who scored the big equalizer in the 2-1 triumph last night in Vancouver. Jarrett Stoll on target and blockered away calmly by Kiprusoff. Terrific energy in the building, as you would expect. Williams with a step. Justin Williams, Kiprusoff comes up large again. Can't quite corral the rebound. Stoll, another opportunity. And Mika Kiprusoff ready again.
Well, less than 24 hours for Los Angeles between the game last night, travel, and getting here. And they are definitely back on their game, and they're making quick movement up the ice. Great feed to Williams. He's looking to pass, and he shoots. The save was made, and the rebound is knocked loose, and then he continued to make things happen. And Mika Kiprusoff very quickly has faced four shots already in the first minute and a half.
Kiprusoff turning aside 29 of 33 on Thursday in the season opener in Edmonton. He was terrific. TJ Brody in just his second National Hockey League encounter. Stellar in the preseason to earn a spot. Hanzus dishes it off. Jacob Muzzin in just his second game in the National Hockey League. Blocked and went over top of the net. Wayne Simmonds is the Kings with some early jump to begin the contest. And Party shaking. He went down awkwardly. Glenn Cross, Bernier rebound, jamming away at it. Jackman there too. And Jonathan Bernier answers the bell early as well.
Great saves for Bernie to get himself his season started, but Adam Party went to throw a big check at Simmonds. Simmonds lost an edge as he was turning, and then all of a sudden Party flew right over top and fortunate enough to tuck his head out of the way, but looks like he jammed that shoulder, left shoulder, as he was able to get control of his head and get it out of the way.
Receiving some attention from Shad Richie at the bench. And Charlie, indeed, it does look to be that left shoulder area for the product of Bonavista, Newfoundland. Giordano towards Jokinen, back out again with Aginla and Alex Tanguay. Jerome Aginla. Johnson, intercepted clearing attempt. Jokinen on the stick of Dustin Brown, and now Johnson takes over. Coming off a career-high 36-point season for the Kings last year. Brown sends it toward the net, gobbled up by Giordano, reverses the breakout to Bomeister. Played just over 2.5 minutes of the opening period. Jokinen a wrister, no trouble for the youngster Bernier. Ryan Smith plays it on left wing to Anze Kopitar with Dustin Brown, the captain of the Kings. Kopitar weaving for Jack Johnson, weak shot. Did make its way through to Kiprusoff. Brown in front, centered it, just missed both. Kopitar and Drew Doughty, who could not corral it at the line. Doughty dishes it off to himself. Doughty busting the words in that raw by Kiprusoff. There's why he was a Norris finalist last season.
Boy, in such great confidence. We mentioned that you won't be 21 till the first week of December, and he has had himself a good 2 years already in the National Hockey League and not afraid to jump up into the play. And Terry Murray has actually encouraged it a lot more this year for Johnson and Doughty to jump up into the play.
Doughty in his third National Hockey League season. Craig Conroy in his 992nd NHL game to Stefan Meyer. Leaves it for Ian White. White will shoot it on the short side. Turned aside by Bernier. White for Brett Sutter. Hit hard by Jacob Muzzin. Sutter protects the puck. Muzzin knocks it away from him. And the Kings will start away with Davis Drewiski. Braden Schenn, the Kings' first-round pick a year ago in 2009, and was he impressive in just his second-ever game last night in Vancouver. Justin Williams blocked in front there. Schenn going to the net and kind of lost an edge as he tried to pull it to the backhand.
Boy, you're seeing a lot more confidence in these young players very quickly. You get an offside call here. Players coming into this league and showing the confidence. And Doughty, again, another one, as you mentioned, Peter, just his third year. Good cycle down low, and as the puck goes to the front, Schenn gets it, but he ends up stepping on the puck himself. And here's that play. Doughty jumping up into the play, little bounced off the boards to himself, and then not afraid to cut hard to the net. 9 out of 10 times players are going behind the net, but showing a lot of courage driving towards that net.
Doughty scored 16 goals last season. TJ Brody. Breakout pass and a good one. Hagman deflects it to the Kings line. 5-4 shots on goal early. It's been relatively wide open to begin. Jarrett Stoll for Brad Richardson weaves into the zone. Richardson, a couple of good moves and a good shot. And again, Kiprusoff makes the save.
Well, a big thing that Brent Sutter wants his team to do is definitely, as he mentioned, play with your brains. You can have all the energy and all the effort out there, but you've got to play within yourselves, play within the system that they have developed here. And he wants his team to be a miserable team to play against here in Calgary.
And the coach preaching how he'd like to see this building become very, very difficult to play in again for visitors.
Boy, I can remember those days. They had huge teams back then, and it was miserable to come in here. You knew you had to be in your top of your game.
Flames with Backlund, Glenn Cross, and Jackman. Giordano will wheel back to touch it for icing.
Terry Murray having himself a great year last year. Boy, his team really played well for him, and especially on the road last year, where they end up with 24 victories. Terry Murray had some coaching in Washington, Philadelphia, and of course the Panthers in Florida. And he is really the type of coach to take these young players and bring them along quickly and obviously intelligently.
Kings were tied with those victories for first in road wins, and they already have one to their credit this season. And not in an easy place to win, Vancouver. Wayne Simmonds rings it towards newcomer Alexei Ponikarovsky. Willie Mitchell, another newcomer, and that's absolutely no trouble for Kiprusoff, who saw it all the way.
Mitchell, definitely a player that the fans here in Calgary know a lot of all those years in Vancouver, and some great dust-ups with the captain, Jerome McGinless. So haven't really seen that matchup tonight, so we'll keep an eye on it.
Missed a lot of action last year with a concussion. He was hit into the boards in Vancouver in a January 16th game by Pittsburgh's Evgeny Malkin and did not return. Ryan Smith working diligently on the wraparound. On his knees, couldn't poke the second try at Kiprusoff. Skideri with a Ginla bearing down on him. Kopitar pinching his Ian White effectively. Skideri reverses to Jack Johnson. Johnson will shoot it in and he'll give chase. Good play by Kiprusoff to send it towards Aguilo. The puck came outside the zone, so the Kings will have to clear it, and they still haven't. Ian White, a career season for him between Toronto and here in Calgary. Signed a 1-year deal, just shy of $3 million in the offseason. Kopitar He'll play it on the wing for Kyle Clifford. He's just 19 years of age. Sutter to Conroy with Stefan Meyer. Shot well wide of the target off the stick of Conroy. Battling Brown, plays it out to the neutral zone. Jacob Muzzin, the Ontario Hockey League's defenseman of the year last year with the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, and a surprising member, I would say, of this opening weekend lineup for the Kings.
Well, it's amazing the young players that the LA Kings have had in their camp, and Dean Lombardi had mentioned earlier today that the only reason that they're here is they deserve to be here. They made the team.
Rennie Bourque away from the puck, and he is in all kinds of difficulty trying to collect himself. I wonder if Dustin Brown was involved. Trying to track down the puck, didn't see it. Flames with a 3-on-2. Brendan Morrison, shot on goal by Jackman, looking for his first of his flame. Giordano, that hit Jackman in front, looking to provide a screen. And we'll keep an eye on Rennie Bourque. That did not look very good in a season for the Flames that's already been plagued with injuries, without the likes of Stage and Moss and Kotalik and Damon Lanko. Backlund wins the battle and makes a good pass. Jumping up is Giordano. Hagman, penalty on its way to the Kings. Bouwmeester on target through a screen. Bernier found it and stopped it. You're watching TELUS Flames Hockey on Rogers Sportsnet. In those three wins and in the
Rennie Bourque turning to go up ice and coming the other way. Kevin Westgarth, all 6'4", 228 pounds, and they have a mean collision right there. As Rennie Bourque did not see Westgarth at all, and he really hobbled to get up off the ice. Definitely a little woozy at that point. Still on the bench.
Rennie Bourque coming off a career season, and there's Kevin Westgarth in the penalty box for hooking. That was not the penalty. And the Flames, whose power play was 0-for-4 in Edmonton on opening night, and they spent plenty of time working on it in practice yesterday in the buildings involved. Tange into the zone, dealing with Michael Hanzus. Giordano returns it to Alex Tange. Bouwmeester moves down at Ginla. Shot block, and it took a bite out of Alexei Ponikarovsky. Great feed, Giordano to Tange. Through the seam, Giordano. Blocked by Drew Doughty. Good movement to start the power play for the Flames. Looking for the game's first goal. Hanzus scoots to a loose puck and makes no mistake as he backhands it right to Mika Kiprusoff with 1:04 to go on the penalty to Westgarth. Jay Bouwmeester, Flames change their forwards. Backlund with Brendan Morrison and Nicholas Hagman. Dustin Brown in the corner, pestered by Michael Backlund, clears it. TJ Brody, nice work to hold it in to Ian White. Kings very aggressive on the penalty kill.
And that's where you want to make sure that that first pass is a good one. You see guys like Brown out there, they're very quick. You make the pass, they're going to be aggressive, you can trap them.
TJ Brody fans. Puck ends up in deep where he wanted it. Bernier likes to play the puck. Ian White anticipates. Willie Mitchell can't clear it by the product of Steinbeck, Manitoba. Doughty off the boards, chip. Again, it's Brody able to hold it in, but Brody looks like he's on his way to the penalty box for hooking. Hockey know-how brought to you by the Home Depot. Proud to build hockey in your community.
Well, they're working on this power play, as we talked about, with the captain. They want him to back out of the slot area where the gray area is. So he comes right to the top of the pitcher. Now, all of a sudden, he's going to back himself out. The key is Tange along the near side boards. He'll start to set things up. All of a sudden, everybody leaves him, and now he's in a great shooting position. The center of the ice lets it go. Unfortunately, he was blocked on the way to the net. So we'll keep an eye on that as the game proceeds.
Good opportunity with it right there. 10 seconds to go in the Westgarth infraction, and then the Kings will enjoy the power play for the first time. They scored their lone goal in the late stages of the third. Justin Williams did on a power play. Ryan Smith. Pass blocked by Brett Sutter. Doughty will carry in. Doughty scored 9 of his 16 goals on the power play last season. A fortuitous carom. Had the puck come out of the zone as Glenn Cross takes a run at Drew Doughty.
Well, that's two big hits that Doughty has received tonight. First to Rene Bork, and that one away from the play. Glenn Cross really puts him into the boards.
Kings with a power play. Good feed. Kopitar. Smith wanted the youngster Braden Shin as Kopitar pulls Conroy down, and Ian White rifles it the length of the ice.
Very aggressive penalty kill for the Flames. And again, that goes along with the idea of making it tough for teams to play in this building.
Justin Williams dealing with Glenn Cross and White. White tripped up a little bit by Hanzus. Johnson, good stick by Curtis Glenn Cross, who's been involved early, and that's a good sign. And Glenn Cross and White combined to send the puck out of the zone with 37 to go in the Kings' first power play of the evening.
Good puck support. You have one player, as we talked about, the Flames being aggressive on the penalty kill. You have to have someone coming in to help to clear that puck.
Dustin Brown, always a league leader in hits, at 8 last night in Vancouver. Bouwmeester off the boards effectively and down the ice. And the Kings with one last rush with time winding down on TJ Brody's minor. Kyle Clifford backhands it to Kiprusoff, shovels it to Robin Regier. And Brody's out of the penalty box. An effective kill for the Flames, who were 15th in the league in that department last season. Giordano to Ian White. Rink wide on the stick of Jerome McGinley. To Tongue with room. Tongue! And Bernier made it look relatively easy. Stopping fellow Quebecer, Alex Tongue.
This period brought to you by Toyota's More For You 2010 Clearout. Toyota's More For You Clearout. On now.
Tune in Thursday for the next TELUS Flames Hockey on Sportsnet. The Flames homestand continues as the Florida Panthers pay a visit. Coverage begins at 7:30 Mountain Time, 8:30 Central on Sportsnet Flames. Regional restrictions apply. For Sportsnet Flames channel information, visit sportsnet.ca/1.
Panthers starting a Western Canadian trip tonight in Edmonton against the Oilers. We'll keep you posted on how that game's going. Puck high in the air, batted down by Dustin Brown to Jake Kopitar. Charlie, the Flames held Kopitar to one assist in four games last season.
Well, they're really making sure that you identify the most dangerous guy on the ice, and definitely it's him, and they took care of business.
Not easy to do. He had 81 points, a career high last season. Ryan Smith can't corral it. Willie Mitchell holds it in towards Kopitar with Smith and Dustin Brown. Giordano away from Ryan Smith. Back pass and a good one to Bouwmeester. Excellent work by Giordano. Pass goes off the stick of Ole Jokinen at center. 7-7 the shots. Kopitar gets free. Backhand in between the legs of Kiprusoff, but out the other way.
Well, you can see how gifted he is offensively. And again, at only 23 years old, he is just getting better.
Seems like he's been in the league for 10 years already.
Going against a pretty good goaltender there in Kiprusoff, though.
Doughty can't quite get there to hold it in. 7-7 officially are the shots on goal. Entertaining, fast-paced first period. Justin Williams into the zone. His shot, that's blocked. There's Regier taking care of Jarrett Stoll, who was heading towards the net. A battle at 28. Nicholas Hagman towards Ian White, who has it now. And in behind Hagman. Williams turned back by Tim Jackman in his first year as a Flame. Signed in the offseason as a free agent. Spent the last couple of years with the Islanders. and can be a real pain in the you-know-what to play against. Skideri in behind the net, finds the stick of Brad Richardson. To Justin Williams, sharp angle, stopped. Skideri blocked, and a good effort that time by Stefan Meyer. Brody blocked that shot into the corners. The Kings still buzzing. Williams again with control. Watched closely by Brody. Stays with him. Kick towards Richardson. Brendan Morrison. Brody swings it on the board. Skideri there to hold it in. Flames desperately trying to exit the zone. And should be able to now. Morrison the outlet to Brody, and Stefan Meyer trying to make his way past Jack Johnson, and Johnson held him up enough to be penalized. Stefan Meyer draws a Jack Johnson penalty, and when we return, the Flames will be back on the power play.
Grab your phones for the first period TELUS Mobile Master Trivia Contest. Text CGY, followed by the letter of your correct answer to 101010. You can win Flames tickets. Here's your question. Which Flames scored the team's season-opening first goal in Calgary's 5-3 home win against the Canucks last year? Was it Mark Giordano, Ray Bourque, or David Moss?
Jack Johnson in the penalty box for interference on Stefan Meyer. Flames have their second opportunity on the power play.
Did not manage a shot with their first opportunity. Kings were just 20th in the league last year in terms of penalty killing. They gave up a power play goal last night in Vancouver on 5 Canuck attempts. Willie Mitchell, the former Canuck, to Hanzus, and he'll sweep it by Bomeister down the ice. Mark Giordano, a career high 11 goals and 30 points last season. Intercepted by Kopitar, and again the Flames will have to go back to regroup.
One of the hardest things that for a successful power play is, yes, you want to be set up in the offensive zone, but getting there as quick as possible with taking away the least amount of time is so important. That's part of setting it up.
Making good entries. Drewiski will once again send the Flames back. And the faithful already impatient. Brendan Morrison off the stick of Nicholas Hagman. Drew Doughty knocked him down. Jared Stoll's backhander. Hagman leaves it at the line for TJ Brody. Down low, Backlund tries to sweep it by Bernier. Another whack at it. And Bernier stayed with him. He's been sharp early. Ian White able to hold it in at the line towards Michael Backlund. Drewiski pokes it away from him, and Drewiski dealing with a rolling puck, and Jarrett Stoll backhanded down the ice.
That's the key, getting aggressive, chasing down those loose pucks. Remember, you've got the extra man out on the ice, so you should be sending two men to that pocket every shift.
White, good left wing feed to Sutter, Brett Sutter. Willie Mitchell, penalty to Johnson about to expire, and does. Flames with one shot from Michael Backlund on that power play. Glenn Cross awaits. Intercepted in the neutral zone by Dustin Brown. Brown is shot. Blocked by Robin Regier. Bomeister. Cross corner shoot in off the board. Glenn Cross let it go with authority. And Bernier made the save on the short side. Braden Shin to Brown with Muzzin. Muzzin to Shin, hocked over his stick, the youngster from Saskatoon. Muzzin, did he hold that in? No.
Pick the best players with props or choose the winning teams with pools. Win big with two new games from Sports Select at your local lottery retailer.
And Sutter looking up and down his bench. Definitely, we have not seen the return of Adam Party or Rene Bourque since the earlier collisions in this first period. So he has a shortened bench to work with right now. He's have to really manage that very well for the rest of the game.
Been a tough season to begin in the injury department, and maybe getting worse. Bourque was really shaken on that collision with Westgarth. And Party looked like he was dealing with a bit of a shoulder issue. Aguila, good pass. Ian White, he'll flip it. And held by Jonathan Bernier.
Finger cook over 100 different menu items tonight at bostonpizza.com.
Well, Stephen Meyer getting a little bit more ice time tonight. Starts pushing and shoving, first with Jack Johnson, and then he wasn't done there. Justin Williams gets involved, so the Youngsters already with one scrap in the season.
What a thrill for Stephen Meyer. Grew up as a Flames fan in Fox Valley, Saskatchewan, just outside of Medicine Hat, where he played junior hockey. This is the team that he loved growing up. So to play for this team in this city, in this building, you know there's a lot of emotion going through him in his sixth National Hockey League game. The 25-year-old, and I thought he was one of the better Flames in Edmonton. Yep. On Thursday.
Definitely did play with an edge, and that's something you've got to hate to do, is hate to lose. Obviously, the Battle of Alberta, you hate to lose, but you've got to show up and make it known and make it nasty the rest of the series.
Robin Regier in behind Conray. Nice take by the 39-year-old to shoot it in. Hagman bumped a little bit with Bernier. This is Wayne Simmonds, and Regier steps up on him in the neutral zone. Doughty to his partner, Willie Mitchell. Mitchell blasts it. Kiprusoff leaves it for Robin Regier. Olli Jokinen in his second tour of duty. Signed as a free agent to a two-year deal in the offseason. Jokinen carries in a wrist shot and a good one. And a fine stop by the blocker of Jonathan Bernier. Jokinen, Tongay in behind the defense, but that pass just failed to find his stick.
Very slow to develop, but Jokinen takes his time coming up the ice and is able to gain possession into that offensive zone right here. Heads up looking for somebody. Everybody backs off, and what he does at that point, he allows the defenseman to come in front of him, let him use it as a screen, and Bernier had to come up with a big save.
Jokinen last season scored 11 times with the Flames and 35 points in 54 games before the February trade to the New York Rangers. Jokinen tracks it down to the captain, Jerome Iginla, with Alex Tanguy. Johnson in a tussle with Iginla. Good feed. Tanguy blocked by Scuderi. Into the final minute of the opening frame. Giordano quickly in the skates of Tanguy. Giordano couldn't quite hold it in. And the Flames will clear the zone.
Make a quick line change, too. Again, with those two players out of the lineup, we'll have a checkup in between periods to see who they are. You really have to make sure your shifts are very short.
12-8, shots on goal in favor of the Flames. Backlund with speed, along with Jackman. Michael Backlund in his new number, number 11. Pickpocketed by the other 11, Kopitar. And then on the backtrack himself, there's Backlund with some nice work. And a penalty. High sticking is going to be the call, and it's going to go to the Flames' Robin Regier with just under 15 seconds remaining.
2 minutes for high sticking.
So as the puck pursuit coming back up, just reaching in. A little bit of contact with Backlund starting to go back up the ice. Stick coming up and catching Dustin Brown.
Kings with their second power play. They won't have a lot of time to work with. Jarrett stole another faceoff when Justin Williams' wrist shot hit a body. Stoll won 81.8% of his faceoffs in Vancouver last night. Hanzu's backhander, Kiprusoff apiece. Buzzer goes.
This period brought to you by Toyota's More For You 2010 Clearout. Toyota's More For You Clearout. On now.
Still looking for our first goal in this Flames home opener through 20. Our new look Flames panel and Hockey Central at the intermission. Coming your way shortly. First period scoring summary brought to you by Mayfair Diagnostics, the official supplier of MRI and CT scan to the Calgary Flames, because the Flames need to know now. The Flames suffering a couple of key injuries in that period. One to Rennie Bork, who collided with Kevin Westgarth, and Brent Sutter right now without defenseman Adam Party, who went into the boards in an odd way. And the Flames start the period with 1:46 remaining in a penalty to Robin Regier. And we understand that both Bork and Party still being evaluated in the Flames dressing room. Michael Backlund fans on a clearing attempt. Kopitar to Jack Johnson of the Kings power play, their second of the evening. Swept off his stick by Backlund. Giordano towards Backlund. Kopitar knocked it down, and then Backlund forced it out.
Interesting penalty killers, Tange and Backlund. The youngsters obviously with Party in the dressing room and Regier in the box down to four defensemen.
And no Rennie Bork, who led the Flames in shorthanded goals last season with 4 of their 8. Kopitar has it hot by him and Jay Bomeister, who played 10 minutes and 14 seconds to lead everyone in that period, shoots it the length of the ice.
Well, just one shift for Adam Party, as you mentioned, with the injury. So just 43 seconds. So, yes, you're going to see Giordano Bomeister pick up a lot of that extra time.
Justin Williams, hands Zeus, and now Jarrett Stoll. Shot deflected in front by Dustin Brown, but went wide. Jacob Muzzin. Michael Hanzus, his shot through a partial screen. Kiprasov, another good save. He's made many. TJ Brody, nice stick. And an excellent play by the young defenseman. But Justin Williams able to hold it in. Jarrett Stoll down low in the corner to Dustin Brown. Brown returns the favor to Jarrett Stoll. Penalty at about to expire. Brown, he'll shoot it short side. Good save again by Kiprasov. Brody away from Brown. And he'll skate it to center before flipping it in. Just the one shot on that Kings power play as the Flames penalty killers with some fine work. Jerome Iginla, Alex Tange finds it in his feet. Tange moves laterally to Iginla, and it's knocked off his stick by Willie Mitchell. And Jerome Iginla has seen no shortage in the last few years of Willie Mitchell.
Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's game is Kraft Salad Dressing.
Well, you talked about the captain, obviously, with his matchup against Willie Mitchell. Still back at it tonight again, different teams.
Shot by Alexei Ponikarovsky, gloved and held by Kiprasov, just past the 2.5 minute mark. Obviously, the second period.
Obviously, the captain looking to really start lighting it up here a little bit more offensively, down to 32 goals last year. And again, it's just not just an individual situation when it comes to scoring goals. I think having the combination of Tange back in his lineup, I think he is the type of guy that can find Jerome Iginla. He definitely had some history in those 2 years they were together.
Dustin Brown tipped in front and kicked away by the left pad of Kiprasov. The Kings top unit out there with Kopitar, Brown, and Ryan Smith. Brandon Morrison, that does come outside and carried back in.
Pick the best players with props or choose the winning teams with pools. Win big with two new games from Sports Select at your local lottery retailer.
Brett Sutter, the son of Flames general manager Daryl Sutter, on the ice with Craig Conroy and Stefan Meyer. Brett Sutter with a tremendous playoff in Abbotsford last spring, and Stefan Meyer has drawn his second penalty of the game.
Yeah, Kevin Westgarth again, he's their physical player, 6'4", we talked about right off the faceoff. Very undisciplined here as the Kings actually won the faceoff. And Stefan Meyer trying to go after it, just a quick stick between the legs, and then took his feet out from underneath him.
Westgarth, his second penalty. He's no stranger to being in the penalty box. 180 minutes last year in the American Hockey League with Manchester.
Terry Murray looking very unhappy with that, because you look at that fourth line, they're only going to get maybe 6 or 7, maybe 8 quality minutes a game. You've got to maximize those minutes you're out there. You can't be taking penalties like that.
Flames' third power play and a clean faceoff win by Olli Jokinen. Tongan again left from Jokinen from a sharp angle, forced Bernier to make a pretty good stop.
Going back to the penalty killers of the Kings, they're very aggressive, so it's so important to make sure those passes are right on for the power play of the Flames.
Jokinen backhands it in. Bernier sweeps it. Giordano pinching down with Iginla. Iginla knocked down by Willie Mitchell, and Michael Hanzus slides at the length of the ice. Bomeister. Long pass and a beauty to Tongay, trying to cut by Drewiski. Tongay then lost his balance, and Kopitar rags it back in the other direction. Kopitar and Brown, shorthanded. Giordano trying to cut off Dustin Brown with some help now from Jokinen. And it's poked right back to Drew Doughty. And Doughty uses the boards to send it behind the Flames net with 51 seconds to go in the penalty to Westgaard. Giordano to Michael Backlund. Drewiski first to it. To Doughty, through his legs. Ryan Smith ran into Michael Backlund. And forcing out of the zone is Brad Richardson. Off the heel of Hagman's stick. Tracking it down is Brendan Morrison. Morrison dumped by Drew Doughty. Took him down heavily. Backlund still with it. Doughty involved with Morrison in front of the net. White a shot. Looked like it went off Bernier's glove. TJ Brody. Good feed. Ian White through the seam. Blocked. Still loose. Bernier swept it as the penalty comes to an end, and here's Westgaard on the pass from Ryan Smith. TJ Brody and Westgaard helped out by Brad Richardson. Richardson comes out of the corner with it, tries the cycle. Brody broke it up, and Brody takes over.
Again, a great opportunity for the Yorkshire to get a little bit more ice time because of the injury to Party, and showing that confidence right from training camp.
Morrison slides it in softly, but the Flames offside.
Well, the Flames get some possession in the offensive zone on the power play, and just a lot of bodies. First the battle, Doughty out there with Morrison, and then everybody regroups, shot just wide on that point from the shot from White, and then again everybody flows back to the front of the net, and that's where you want to have a lot of traffic, a lot of red jerseys in front of Bernier.
Brendan Morrison signed by the Flames. It's prior to the start of the season. Free agent, had 42 points with the Washington Capitals last season, the 35-year-old from Pitt Meadows. Flames are excited to see him scoring for them, Charlie, rather than against. He's done very well against the Flames in his career.
Boy, he really has, in big goals too, if I can remember properly.
You're remembering properly. Johnson, good stick by Glenn Cross to block it. Giordano paired with Regier. Flames down to 5 defensemen in the game with the injury to Party. Braden Schenn. Schenn centered it. And Glenn Cross trying to backhand it up, but he hit Justin Williams with it. Jarrett Stoll back pass. Drive neatly. Schenn. Kiprasov took a peek, but he's got it. Braden Schenn that close to his first NHL goal, but Mika Kiprasov would have none of it.
Well, just second game out of training camp, but you still have to be stronger on the puck, especially at end of a long shift. Here, Glenn Cross doesn't get it out, and all of a sudden it's just a fire drill after that. Jarrett Stoll is able to get it back. And Schenn, as you mentioned, I'd probably like to have that shot back a little bit. Really did not get a lot on it. But that's where the Flames, if they have control and you get control of it, keep your feet moving, and you want to move that puck north. You don't want to be going east and west. Get it north and get it out.
13-13, the shots on goal. Last three games of last season's set to between these clubs. All were 2-1 finals. Looks like we're headed in that kind of direction again this evening. Block shot by Robin Regier off the stick of Alexei Ponikarovsky in his second game as a King. Wayne Simmonds, Kanzus, and Ponikarovsky. Back pass intercepted by Ian White and cleared off the glass and out. Jacob Muzzin. Simmonds one-touch pass to Ponikarovsky off the skate of Ian White. Alex Tanguy. Cross-corner shooting. Scampering in after it is Hagman with good speed. Willie Mitchell fends him off, and Ponikarovsky will leave it for Willie Mitchell. The 33-year-old, that's one of the reasons he opted for 33. He's worn number 8, but I think that's occupied in this lineup. You're not getting it from that guy.
No, definitely that would be wearing number 8 for many, many years in Los Angeles.
Terrific pass, Tanguy to Aginla, who ripped it and may have gone off the knob end of the stick of Bernier. Tanguy to the front. Jokinen had a whack at it. Flames with the most pressure they've enjoyed in this second period, but Bernier foiling Jerome Aginla, who has 54 career points in 51 games against the Kings. Bouwmeester to Aginla. Aginla notched a hat trick in L.A. last season on the 21st of November.
Again, definitely his part of his game is shooting that puck, but you mentioned it earlier, Bernier looks very good between the pipes for Los Angeles.
Curtis Glencross in deep on the forecheck with Brendan Morrison. Jerome Aginla remains out there. Jack Johnson fishes it out of Glencross's feet to Justin Williams. Plays it to center. And Scuderi slaps it past T.J. Brody. Brody, best asset, his feet. Tapped off his stick. Johnson. Dangerous pass, but got away with it to Jarrett Stoll with speed. Stoll drives the net, poked away by Kiprasov. Then he stopped Brad Richardson from close range.
Players now with that plastic footing into the net, not afraid to drive hard to the net. Very, could have been a very costly pass here on the backhand. You can see it right there. Gets it to Stoll, and then he just drives hard to the net. Good poke check. You see Brody getting back with the stick. Kiprasov holding ground in front of the net. And that's where it's so important. Right there, Kiprasov very aggressive with that poke check.
Kiprasov has been superb again. Bouwmeester to Nicholas Hagman. King's really doing an excellent job, Charlie, of taking away Flames' time and space, especially at the blue line.
Really not enough time to get plays set up through the neutral ice zone, and that's where you want to gain your speed. So a little bit of adjustment for the Flames, probably generate a little bit more as you're coming out of your defensive zone.
Well, that's another thing the Flames have worked very hard at since the Thursday night loss in Edmonton. Brett Sutter one-hands it. Can he get around Doughty? And Doughty recovered just in the nick of time. Sutter had a step on him. Kyle Clifford blocked by Mark Giordano, who had 6 shot blocks in Edmonton in game 1 to lead the way in that department. Backlund content to bank it off the boards down the ice as we are nearing the 10-minute mark of the second period. Pace has not been the same in period 2 as it was in the opening period.
Well, for the Flames, definitely they want to try and pick it up, even though they're down a couple men, because L.A. playing last night, a late game in Vancouver. They lose an hour on the flight, and of course, opening night ceremonies delayed the game last night.
A penalty away from the puck. We'll straighten that out when we return.
Time for part 2 of the TELUS Mobile Master Trivia Contest. Text CGY and the letter of your answer to 101010. A chance to win Flames tickets. This current Flame was traded at the OHL deadline last year from the Saginaw Spirit to Barrie, leading the Colts to the OHL Finals. Which one was it? T.J. Brody, Brian Cameron, or was it Mitch Wall?
Well, in the box, Clay Conroy, a little extra push at the end of the play. Got that elbow up a little bit high, ended up with a roughing call, so LA gets another opportunity on the power play.
Robin Regier almost finding the stick of Brendan Morrison, shorthanded. Flames scored 8 shorthanded goals last season. Jack Johnson maneuvers into the zone. Brendan Morrison anticipates and clears it the length of the ice.
Great job by Morrison. First of all, winning that faceoff in the defensive zone. And then right away, you can see all of a sudden LA's back on its heels and trying to get things set up.
Curtis Glenn Cross forcing Jack Johnson back to Drew Doughty. Returns it. Johnson and Kopitar led all the Kings last year with 14 power play goals. That was third in the league. Kopitar brings it to the right point. Johnson back to Andre Kopitar. Braden Shen and Ryan Smith up front with him. The 19-year-old Shen, Kopitar off the stick of Brett Sutter. Sutter will spin, find Glenn Cross. Can he move in on net? Glenn Cross, backhander, he scores! Shorthanded goal in the Flames' first of the season.
Well, you can see how having active sticks and being aggressive on the penalty kill can make things work. Sutter gets it up in the air first, and then it's just a mad drill. Get it to Glenn Cross. He gets way ahead of him. Surprising Bernier didn't come out and be a little bit more aggressive from that bad angle. But Glenn Cross with his head up, good head of steam, just out, races that puck, misses the poke check. And there's the first goal of the season for the Calgary Flames, a shorthanded effort by Glenn Cross.
Glenn Cross, first goal period of the season. He had 3 of his 15 last year shorthanded as well. And Brett Sutter draws the assist. Still 25 to go in the Kings' power play. Giordano steals it from Dustin Brown and makes no mistake using the boards to send it down the ice.
So now you're getting the atmosphere in the building. You're getting everybody excited. Not only was it a goal, but it was a shorthanded effort. So Flames have to continue to capitalize on that.
Jokinen spots it. Ian White clears it, and that'll do it for the Conroy penalty. Flames not only kill it off, but they score shorthanded. Jokinen past Bomeister at the blue line. Jerome Iginla has a little extra burst in his step now, too. Willie Mitchell nearly turned it over to Nicholas Hagman. Jokinen to Bomeister in his skates, and Brody takes over. Brody's pass hit Brad Richardson. Back comes Wayne Simmonds. Simmonds blocked up by Brody, and Brody finds Stefan Meyer at center. Meyer and Scuderi after it on the end boards. Regier pinches. Ponikarovsky works one-on-one with Giordano. Giordano blocked it, and that came quickly off the end boards right to Kiprasov. On behalf of Safeway Score and Win and Kraft Salad Dressing, Tom McGregor of Crossfield has won a Hitachi 18-volt cordless drill kit. And Jose Pereira of Thompson, Manitoba has also won a Hitachi 18-volt cordless drill. Congratulations to both, courtesy of Curtis Glenn Cross, who records, as you see right there, career point 100.
Well, that's a big goal, too. Again, you're looking at, with the injuries so far in the lineup tonight, a lot of mixed-max lines out there. So it's going to be a situation where players like that have to seize the moment, especially in the home opener like this.
Time of that shorthanded goal. It's past the 11-minute mark of this period.
For every goal the Flames score this season on Sportsnet, Supreme Basics will donate $100 to the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation with The Goal is the Cure. Supreme Basics, Canada's largest independent office supply company. Check out supremebasics.com.
Glenn Cross from Sutter, shorthanded at 11:31. And the Flames with their first lead of the season. Braden Shin tied up by Craig Conroy. Stefan Meyer held in by Davis Krewitzky. It's caught up in his equipment. He wants a stoppage. Referees say play on, and the puck finally drops down to Braden Shin. Conroy. Brody on right wing for Tim Jackman. Jackman working against Muzzin. There's quite a collision. Meyer dumps Braden Shin in the slot. Jackman set up well, and he just slid it wide. Jackman looking for his first as a Flame.
Here, there's a great example of the quality ice time that you can get on that fourth line, especially with Meyer out there. And Conroy with Jackman, a good scoring opportunity and a couple big hits. So you utilize the small amount of time you'll have.
The building definitely in it after the shorthanded goal. Jokinen from a sharp angle. Tongay just out of the reach of Jerome McGinley. Back comes Ponikarovsky with Wayne Simmonds. Another shot blocked by Giordano. Tongay, Aginla with Jokinen. Giordano looking to move up on the play. Aginla, Giordano, and Skinneri took care of that with a fine block, and it hurt him. He's shaken up.
Well, again, there's the what we talk about earlier, getting the green light for the defenseman to jump up into the play and try to make the offense a lot stronger.
Willie Mitchell, signed as a free agent in the offseason by the Kings. Smith to Kopitar on Jake Kopitar. Hard shot. Kiprasov got over to the near post. And there was just a little room there, too. Mitchell keeps it in at the blue line to Kopitar. With Brown and Ryan Smith, Regier reverses in his own zone. Kopitar collects it again. Mitchell to Doughty. Deals with a rolling puck and deals with Glenn Cross, who fends him off well. Backlund carries in. He'll send a one-hopper to Bernier, who does not take any chances. Curtis Glenn Cross, shorthanded. It's the Flames on the board. You're watching TELUS Flames Hockey on Rogers Sportsnet.
This fine feller is our color commentator, Charlie Simmer, an ex-LA King. Great. Prior to the game tonight, the Kings honored Charlie Simmer, players Andrzej Kopitar and Dustin Brown.
Just thought it'd be a nice gesture to, give you your old jersey back. And I just want to say it's an honor for me to wear your number because, obviously we're a King legend and hopefully we can continue that.
Well, thank you very much. And congratulations to you on your start this year in your career. Obviously, I think the number 11's gotten a lot faster and more talented the last couple of years. But, it's a great honor. Thank you very much. And always...
Thank you very much.
Always will be a Kings fan and watch you guys all the time. And obviously, keep an eye on the number 11 to see how many points it's going to get. And it's gotten me a lot in the hockey pools lately, so that's good.
Thanks again. Thank you.
What's this Kings legend stuff? He's a Sportsnet legend wearing forum blue, Charlie.
Well, that's the great color Jack Kent Cook invented. Not purple or yellow. It's forum blue and gold.
Very nice touch. Kopitar out there creating havoc. Backhands it wide. Kings in search of an equalizer. Jerome McGinley with a shot block. And Jokinen starts away. Ole Jokinen leaves it for Tongay. Bomeister moves up. Aginla now, his shot, and another glove save by Jonathan Bernier as we go back to Roger.
Do the Flames have the ultimate wingman? Four lucky voters will win Wing Street Wings for a year from Wing Street, delivered by Pizza Hut. Visit sportsnet.ca to vote now.
Well, the captain getting another good scoring opportunity, and what they're trying to teach him, and one of the best in NHL history is Brett Hull, almost to the point where you say he's not even in the play, and all of a sudden on the off wing, he gets that stick in the proper position. He had two great scoring opportunities already here in the second period from just pulling out of that crowded area to get himself into the open.
18-15, the shots in favor of the Flames. Craig Conroy. With Stefan Meyer and Brett Sutter. Good move by Conroy. With another shot blocked by Skinneri, who's had three, I believe, in this period. Stoll. Into the corner. Off the boards to Justin Williams. Williams missed 28 games with a broken leg last season. finds Jack Johnson. Down low for Brad Richardson. Richardson tied up by TJ Brody. Brody swats it to Craig Conroy. And Conroy can't clear the zone. Brody with another attempt goes off the shoulder of Stefan Meyer. And finally it's White to Conroy. Shoots it in and the Flames will look to make changes. Sending out Morrison, Hagman, and now Jerome Iginla. Injuries to Rennie Bork and Adam Party. Flames a short lineup. Kyle Clifford. Clifford and Giordano hustles. Deflected out of play.
Boy, Giordano very quick on his feet. He made the right play at the blue line. It bounced off of him and went behind him. And at that point, Clifford off to the races coming off that left wing. And then Giordano, just a straight line, A to B, take the shortest route. And he was able to get an active stick in there to deflect it up into the mesh.
Kyle Clifford, second round pick in 2009. Star with the Barry Colts last year on their way to the Ontario Hockey League final before losing to the eventual Memorial Cup champions from Windsor. Matter of fact, Charlie, the Barry Colts, TJ Brody, a member of that team, had more wins in the regular season, 5 more than Windsor.
Very good franchise they have up in Barry. I'm not mistaken, the Hall of Famer Dale Hawerchuk will be coaching there this year.
He is indeed. A rebuilding team. Kiprasov. Backhands it to Ian White. Willie Mitchell. Puck bouncing. 2-on-1 developing. Morrison and Hagman. Brennan Morrison. Broken up. Ian White. Off the stick of Morrison. And chopped down the ice by Ponikarovsky.
2-on-1 break as ex-teammates Morrison trying to get that puck up the ice. Gets it away from Willie Mitchell right here. A bouncing puck. And then Doughty does the right play. Plays it well in between. So pretty much at that point, it's a shooting situation for Morrison when you have that defenseman staying right down the middle.
Great play by Doughty. Glenn crossed the game's goal getter. Shorthanded. Backlund. Ponikarovsky carries it to the neutral zone. Glenn Cross stops him. Glenn Cross shorthanded from Brett Sutter. The lone goal at 11:31 of this second period. Mark Giordano, he scored the first goal in the home opener last season against Vancouver. Kopitar shoots it in. Kiprasov, he'll steer it off the glass, past Glenn Cross and out to center. Into the final minute of the second period. Kopitar to Davis Drewiski. Puck bouncing a little bit. Giordano takes a hit to make the play from Dustin Brown. Drewiski in behind Ryan Smith. Remember the battle that Brown and Giordano had in this building last year? That was something else. Boy, did they go at one another. Tange goes at Ryan Smith. Regier eliminates Smith, but Brown to the line. Drewiski again. Flames nearly had a breakaway as Jackman blocked it. Now he'll go to the bench. Jokinen hangs on. Good pass to White off his skate. Iginla, nice move around Kopitar. Feeds it down low. Time winding down. Iginla fanned in the slot. And the Flames will enjoy a 1-0 lead thanks to that gentleman's shorthanded tally. The Flames panel at Hockey Central at the intermission. Coming your way from the Scotiabank Saddle Dome very shortly. Tonight's scoring summary is brought to you by Panago. Before, during, and after the game, it's just got to be Panago. No goals in period number one. And Curtis Glenn Cross, a short-handed tally from Brett Sutter. Sutter's second NHL point in his 16th NHL game. And the Flames lead the Kings 1-0 after two.
definitely saw a lot more jump in the building after that shorthanded goal was scored. It was leading up to it a little bit more aggressive on the penalty kill, and then all of a sudden now some good scoring opportunities to finish off that second period for the hometown team.
Nikki Kiprasov turning aside all 15 that he's faced. Jonathan Bernier, 17 saves in his first start of the season. Jonathan Quick was terrific in the Kings shootout victory in Vancouver one night ago when they were in exactly this same position entering the third period, down 1-0. Ryan Smith with Dustin Brown and Andre Kopitar against the Flames' top unit. Brown is shot. That's blocked. Goes to the open wing. Tanguy collides with Kopitar, able to hold it in with his size and strength. Smith and Brown. Giordano playing with somebody else's stick. Jerome McGinnis. As Kiprasov makes the save.
Definitely the wrong hook on that stick for Giordano. You mentioned that battle last year between Dustin Brown and Giordano. It has continued on tonight's game. And you look at the amount of time for Giordano tonight, 17 minutes and 7 seconds. And then reaching in, and smart thing, he just lets go of the stick on the exchange. And then, of course, the captain farther up the boards on that right side is able to get one off the bench.
Deflected out of play, 38 seconds into the period. Justin Williams, who scored that tying goal with under 5 minutes to go last night in Vancouver.
Well, definitely going to be a big push here early for LA. They realize that, you know, they've had a long night. They've had a short day today, and they're trying to get this thing tied up as early as they can in the third period.
Skinneri tipped off the goal post by Jarrett Stoll. The redirect went doink off the post and stayed out. The Flames with a break early in the third. Brandon Morrison tracks it down in the corner. Centering pass intercepted by Stoll to Williams. A little dangerous as Richardson goes back to Skinneri. Jack Johnson thought about a long lead pass. Stoll and Williams. Off the skate of Robin Regier to Craig Conroy now. Conroy into the zone, scores! Craig Conroy, 2-0 Flames.
Flames able to get that puck right at their own blue line and move up the ice very quickly. And at the end of this play, everybody's going for a line change right here. There's a little soft play up Morrison. Everybody's going to the bench. And all of a sudden, you can see as the veteran moves over to the far side of the ice. And what he's able to do is get the screen set up in front of Bernier. And let's go with a hard, crisp wrist shot using Drewski as a screen.
Craig Conroy scored 3 times in 65 games last season. Has his first in his first game of 2010-2011. And a big one at that, giving the Flames a 2-0 lead right after the Kings had hit the goalpost. Tied up against the boards by Bouwmeester. Lindcross behind the net to TJ Brody to the most recent goal getter. Conroy's pass in the equipment of Backlund. Here's Glenn Cross. Backhander stopped by Bernier as Glenn Cross went in search of his second of the game. Ponikarovsky to Wayne Simmons. Simmons led the Kings in plus minus one season ago at plus 22. Drew Doughty. Willie Mitchell. Head up, finds Kyle Clifford. Clifford and Giordano at the line. And Hagman with his strength backhands it into the King zone.
Well, that's a good play by Hagman. And again, it's a small, innocent type of play. But what it does, it gets themselves out of trouble. They get the puck out of the defensive zone, and then they can work on the offense.
Conroy from Brendan Morrison, who has his first point as a Calgary Flame at 1:20. And our next score and winner, courtesy of Safeway and Kraft Salad Dressing, is Jim Wold of Calgary, who's won a beautiful men's Bull of a Solar watch. And for our viewers tonight in the great province of Saskatchewan, Elizabeth McDougall of Lumsden has also won a men's Bull of a watch, thanks to Craig Conroy's first of the year. And Conroy with 37 career points against the Kings, a team he used to play with. In 46 games now.
Well, now the little things are important for the Flames. The little battles for those loose pucks and making sure they clear the defensive zone, yet still not to the point of falling back and doing a defensive shell.
And the Flames very early in the first lost two key players. Ginla, Arister, and Bernier in good position to make the save.
Again, really stretching out the ice right now. Good outlet pass, and unfortunately for the captain, that's not his bread and butter area to shoot from. And Regier just fires three zones very quickly. Likes to be shooting from that far right face-off circle where he's very dangerous, but you can see that soft pass right on the ice. Had a little mustard on that pass also.
Robin Regier with a 17-point season for the stay-at-home, steady Eddie defenseman. Recorded points, Charlie, in six straight games at one point, Regier. This shot from Regier blocked. Belongs now to Jokinen, remains out with Tanguay, and again, Ginla tipped. That's a pretty good save by Bernier on the deflection.
Pick the best players with props or choose the winning teams with rules. Win big with Toonie Games from SportsElect at your local lottery retailer.
Well, Bernier making a very difficult save look pretty easy. There's a redirect of by the captain on a Ian White shot. Pretty well everybody was kind of relaxed as that shot was going high and wide for the net, and the captain finds it.
Dustin Brown pinching down was Bomeister to keep it alive. Flames with an early goal from Craig Conroy have added to their lead. It's 2-0. Bomeister tried it again. This time it didn't work. Giordano reverse, but out of the reach of Bomeister. Brendan Morrison in deep. Kopitar on the cycle to Ryan Smith. Giordano in the corner. Flips it off the boards, but Kopitar will keep it in and let it go with traffic. And Kiprusoff did well. Jackman carries into the zone with Brendan Morrison. Jackman, nice strong move. Drives. And Kopitar came back along with Johnson to force Jackman wide, but a good shift by the product of Minot, North Dakota. Tim Jackman. Braden Shen hit the linesman. Mike Civic trying to backhand it in deep.
Really different complexion to the game right now, that goal by Conroy. You're looking at a team by LA trying to get themselves back in, and they fall behind by two.
And the Flames' benefactors, too, I would think, Charlie, as this game goes on, you'd like to think, at least, with the Kings playing in a back-to-back scenario.
Well, now you're looking into a psychological part of the game, and it's up for the Flames' continued effort, forcing the play more into the offensive zone, as opposed to just sitting back and say, well, if we can protect and Kipper can make a couple saves, you'll come out of here. You've got to be dying to get that goal number three. You've got to be working hard, yet still, again, being defensively sound.
Well, the Kings have plenty of firepower. And the likes of Smith and Kopitar, Dustin Brown, Stefan Meyer hustling after Drew Doughty. Willie Mitchell to Kevin Westgarth. And it was the Westgarth collision that knocked Rennie Bourque out of the game in the first period. And if you're the Flames, you certainly hope that he is not lost for any length of time. Conroy having words with Doughty. Remember, Conroy took a penalty as he got his elbow up on Doughty in the second period.
Been away from the play. Ian White unhappy with the way he is being treated out there by Westgarth. That's where, again, you definitely want to be showing up to it, but you want to be disciplined, especially in a game like this. Nothing has to change for the Flames, where you're going to see players in LA trying to change the mood in this building, whether it's fisticuffs, a little physical play, or just all-out hard work. So stay away from things like that in this type of game.
Michael Backlund to take the draw against one of the NHL's best, Jarrett Stoll. Jack Johnson tipped in front of the net by Justin Williams. Bomeister, good lead pass to Stefan Meyer. Conroy on the forecheck. Bernier calmly leaves it for Jack Johnson. Williams turned back by Curtis Glencross, who scored that huge shorthanded goal in the second period, 11 and a half minutes into it. Glencross does well to take it and make a good backhand play to Nicholas Hagman. Hagman shoots it in, and he looked like he took Jacob Muzzin's stick up in the chin area. His play continues. A few supporters in the building, I think, that agree. Hagman continue to work diligently on the shift. Kopitar turns back the Slovenian. Kopitar carries in, still with it. Jokinen outlets into the corner. Regier bearing down on the pinching Davis-Drewiski, and Regier, he can make you pay a price, can he? Tongue would have had a clear break. Anticipated, but the pass broke his stick as Scuderi turned it over and really got away with one.
Yeah, it was the more or less looking at it. Do I shoot with a broken stick or do I drop it?
Dustin Brown. Ian White pokes it away from him. Ryan Smith carries on. Smith, Kopitar, Brown headed to the front of the net. Brown bumped Mika Kiprusoff. Ryan Smith in deep. Bouwmeester shoving at him. Kings with the pressure on, trying to get on the board here in the third. Kopitar, Smith and Brown. Doughty looking for an opening. Sweeps it for Smith. Flames staying in their lanes. Tange, an excellent shot block. Here's Jokinen with Aginla. Aginla! Jokinen robbed by goaltender Bernier. And a penalty on its way to the Kings. Bernier may have saved the game. Here's another look.
Well, the Flames come close a couple times. Scuderi through the middle, breaks the stick of Tonga. You can see, do I shoot? What do I do with it? Goes back the other way. And then a great block shot by Tonga. Gets pulled down. The penalty is called. It sets up a two-on-one. Give and go. The captain shoot. Oh, and he gets it across to Jokinen. Jokinen didn't get all of it. I think he wanted to get a little bit more mustard on that upstairs, but a great effort.
Flames with their fourth power play of the game. Craig Conroy scored early in this frame, the 120 mark, to make it 2-0. Brandon Morrison, who assisted on it, out there on the power play with Michael Backlund and Hagman. Bouwmeester and White, and Bouwmeester can't handle the pass.
A lot of bouncing pucks around Bouwmeester tonight.
Ponikarovsky. Ian White knocks him off the puck at the line. Backlund. Broken up by Kopitar. Kopitar and Bouwmeester, and Bouwmeester with some help as he used the linesman to hold up on Jay Kopitar, who I think's been the best King. Jokinen enters the zone and Jack Johnson strips him.
Fresh lineup out now for the Flames. A matter of getting things set up very quickly. We talk about trying to find that third goal, another go-ahead goal.
Aginla in close quarters. Drewiski, Johnson back to the line for the youngster Brody. Giordano spins, finds Tonge. Look how aggressive the Kings are. And the Flames dealt a lot with that in practice yesterday. Aginla just forced it in front. Giordano might have hit Jarrett Stoll. Think it did. Matter of fact, I'm certain it did. Aginla. Jokinen sweeps it to Tonge. Tonge! Aginla! And Bernier stops the Flames captain from close range.
Again, once the Flames got control of it, you're seeing a very aggressive LA King team. Big block shot by Jarrett Stoll right off the get-go, but the Flames continue with some system, and they're very comfortable with the way that they can chase down the loose pucks. And then this one, just a great feed through the middle. Again, all the captain is trying to do is get a good piece of wood on that centering pass from Tonge and try to find a hole.
24-17, the shots down in favor of the Flames. 15 to go in the power play. Jackman to Conroy with Curtis Glencross. Giordano, hard shot through the screen, and Bernier with another big stop.
Again, great aggressive play on the puck. Jackman is the key to this play. Once Giordano gets set up, he's going to shoot, set up right in front. Jackman just turns a split second too late because the puck did drop. And again, when a goaltender's trying to fight a shot through a screen, basically trying to get as big as he can, it's usually just going to hit him, and there will be a rebound.
Great feat, too, by Giordano to get into a shooting lane. Glenn Cross hit Jackman. Jackman on target. Jackman's given the Flames a lot of quality minutes. And the Flames' power play comes to a conclusion. Flames trying to win a season home opener for the second straight year. Glenn Cross, backhander, and he's got a beauty. And Bernier cut it off. Kopitar, as he left the ice, versus Regier. Kopitar in front just missed the stick of Ryan Smith. Jack Johnson just trying to shoot it deep. Regier finds the stick of Glenn Cross to Hagman. Ryan Smith accepts the pass at the line. Kopitar towards Ryan Smith. Regier chops it into the corner. Ian White and Brown. Boy, this building is loud right now, isn't it? Great to hear. Aguilla carries in, makes a great move. Aguilla just slides it wide. Fantastic individual effort by Jerome Aguilla. And he beat Drew Doughty to do it. Stoll offside at the line as Brody broke it up. Here's why this guy's been one of the best in the game for a long time. Almost made it 3-0. Flames Energy Player of the Game is brought to you by Easy Max by NMAX Energy, proud supporter of Small Business Week.
Well, Curtis Glenn Cross killing a penalty with Brett Sutter makes a great effort here, racing down a loose puck, gets to the front of that, avoids the poke check, and gets the first goal of the year. Shorthanded effort, up Flames up 1-0 at that point. He's had four shots on net, he's been very aggressive, and obviously for him to be aggressive, he has to be skating.
Jerome Aguilla with some kind of rush going into the TV timeout. He walked around Drew Doughty and slid it just wide of the far post. Here's a chance. Stephen Meyer rock from close range by Bernier, looking for his first NHL goal in his sixth NHL game. TJ Brody, too hot to handle for Backlund, belongs to Meyer in front. Brett Sutter nearly chipped it by Bernier. This is the kind of play that Brent Sutter and the coaching staff wants to see, Charlie. There's some more energy from Glenn Cross. Jackman, who's provided a little energy of his own with Conroy, who made it 2-0. Jackman again, can't corral it. And Ponikarovsky carries it out and is dumped by Conroy. Williams leaves it for Michael Hanzus. Backhands it in front. Jackman breaks it up. And it came outside the line. Regier goes chest to chest with Alexei Ponikarovsky.
Well, Peter, it's exactly what we talked about in the opening or in the news hit. And first part of the game, making this place a little bit miserable. So instead of sitting back and protecting a two-goal lead, all of a sudden now the Flames, 29 shots on net. They're very aggressive in the offensive zone on the line change. Glenn Cross comes off the bench, and he just doesn't skate into the play. He flies in and gets a big hit, wins the battle for that puck, and sets up a couple good scoring opportunities.
Charlie, there's really nothing Curtis Glenn Cross can't do. He has all the tools. Skate, shoot, hard to play against. When he's right, he's a very valuable piece of this team and has been excellent for the most part tonight. Battling Ponikarovsky on the boards, wins the battle and finds Nicholas Hagman. Glenn Cross leaves it, Morrison, Hagman stopped on the short side. Nice passing by Bernier. Hagman didn't have much of an angle. And Glenn Cross skates off. Simmons, good backtrack by Hagman. and flips it into the Kings territory. Under seven to go in regulation as the Flames look to win their home opener and even the record at 1-1.
Well, you can see how contagious that effort is starting to get. Every line now is almost looking at each other to say who's going to outdo the line that just come off the ice, and definitely something that can build up momentum.
Offside the call.
And a good example is, no matter what the lineup is, the combination, Glenn Cross, drop pass. They give it to Morrison, they give it to Hagman. Trying to go short side again, probably like to have it up a little bit higher. You see these goaltenders really protecting the bottom half of the net. But again, you're getting the shots, you're getting some momentum, and you're keeping the puck way in 200 feet away from your own net and setting up scoring opportunities.
Nicholas Hagman scored four times during the preseason, or make that three times, and 5 points, 25 goals a year ago in his time with the Flames and the Leafs. I really think he's going to be very key to the Flames' hopes this season.
Well, anytime you get a natural goal scorer like that, you get more of a fresher lineup out there, you're going to see some great goals scored by him.
Kopitar's shot blocked. Flames with a wide edge now in Sharps, 30-17. Jokinen breaks his stick, dealing with Ryan Smith. Kopitar trying to feed it down low. Doughty in front to Smith. I'm not sure he was expecting it. Kopitar scores. Not sure if it went off Dustin Brown or not, but the Kings don't go away. They're back in it to within one.
Well, as they did last night, they get themselves back in the game, and unfortunately for Jokinen, he's working along the near side boards, and he breaks his stick as he's working the boards, right there against the boards, had to drop it. Now you're no man's land. Do you go to the bench and get one, or do you try and play defensive hockey? And sure enough, it goes right back to where he's supposed to be. Comes up the side, and then the shot is made off of Brown. And changes direction just inside the far post.
We'll see if it's credited to Kopitar or Brown. The Flames really don't care. All of a sudden, they find themselves in a one-goal game after a few chances to maybe put it away with a third one. Ian White diving at it, trying to get it by Braden Schenn to Brad Richardson with Kyle Clifford. Richardson held up by Backlund. Stephen Meyer off the glass and out of the zone.
Well, this will be interesting to see how the Flames respond to this. They still, again, keep that aggressive style of hockey going, and they'll keep themselves out of trouble.
Jack Johnson. Flames, or make that the Kings, didn't find the net in Vancouver until just under 5 minutes to go. Tonight, just under 6 minutes to go here in the third. And Dustin Brown with his first of the season from Kopitar and Doughty to make it 2-1. Down the stretch we come in the home opener for the Flames. Brown has the Kings on the board.
Please tune in after the game for Sportsnet Connected with R.J. Broadhead. Complete Flames postgame reaction and the NHL coverage you want, including the Panthers and Oilers highlights. That's all up next on Connected.
Kings, well, Dustin Brown finds the net.
Things happen so quickly. Kopitar is the key on that. Not only is it a great shot right along the ice, but he didn't hesitate, didn't set anything up. He was going far post right off the goal.
That line right back out there looking for more. Kopitar and Doughty draw the assists at 14:06. Flames shorthanded, with Rennie Bork and Adam Party leaving this game very early in the first. Kings playing their second game in as many nights. Flames with a 12-4 shots on goal edge in the third. The game hangs in the balance. Iginla tries to change that. Hit Jack Johnson in front. Doughty to Ryan Smith off his stick. Into the Flames zone as Regier hustles back in, both teams making changes. Jackman chips it in for Conroy, who scored early in this third period. Glenn Cross has the other goal. Glenn Cross off the stick of Justin Williams, and Ian White able to hold it in. Conroy knocked down by Jarrett Stoll. Stoll fans on a pass, and there's Glenn Cross in his face. And Stoll able to carry it to center now. On the shoot-in for Justin Williams. Shannon Stoll with him. And that deflects out of play. And now they're talking, the officials, as to whether it deflected or went straight out. If it did deflect, the faceoff needs to come outside the line.
Well, they're definitely saying deflected off the LA King player. They're moving the faceoff out over the blue line. So again, chasing that puck around. White taking a swing at it, and definitely off the stick of the LA King player.
Went off the blade of Justin Williams, who has the other King's goal this season. Wayne Simmons clears it in deep. Ponikarovsky in deep on the forecheck with Hanzus. Hagman. Morris, an excellent outlet to Sutter. Brett Sutter, Bomeister joins him on the rush. Bomeister, a high-rising shot. Brody to Curtis Glenn Cross. To Sutter. Doughty steps up, but Sutter sends it in. Under three to go in regulation now. Johnson and Doughty. And you know it's back out up front. Doughty fan, but it did make its way through to Ryan Smith. White rings it to Jerome McGinley. Came off his stanchion or off the glass and out of the zone. Willie Mitchell intercepted again. Tongue with room. Tongue! Mitchell got back to use that long stick and deflected wide.
Tongue with another broken stick has to go back and leave the offensive zone.
Second of the period, Kopitar with a little room to operate, and Brown. Dustin Brown backhander. Kiprasov makes the save on the short side. Jokinen holds up Ryan Smith and allows Jackman to send it to the King's line. Kopitar into the zone again, but knocked off his stick. Jackman in behind Glenn Cross. Who has it? Curtis Glenn Cross drags it into the corner with Tim Jackman and Conroy. Jackman forced behind the net by Kopitar. Conroy trying to shoot it on target. And a penalty coming up to the Kings for high sticking. The work of Jackman paying off.
Looks like Richardson got the stick up. They're both battling for that puck on the far corner. And Jackman, again, both sticks looking for that loose puck. And that's a big play right there. The enthusiasm and the play of Jackman, again, keeps the play going in the offensive zone, and it draws a penalty.
Brad Richardson coming off a career year for the one-time draft pick of the Colorado Avalanche in the penalty box of the Flames on the power play with 1:35 to go. Cleared down the ice by Drew Whiskey. And the Flames, Coach Sutter talking a lot all week about intelligent play. Bernier, and he'll look to exit the net. Aginla lost an edge, and here comes Doughty. Drew Doughty, pleading in front, just missed Willie Mitchell. Hanzus intercepts at center. Ponikarovsky leaves it. Kopitar. Kings are shorthanded. Kopitar. Here comes Bernier out of the net. Kopitar can't jam it by Kiprasov on the short side. Net empty. Giordano, a safe play out of his own zone. Jack Johnson rings it. There's White. Has an empty cage. White blocked by Mitchell. Robin Regier hit Ryan Smith with it. Then it hit the linesman. Hagman with an empty net. Nicholas Hagman to put it away.
good hard work leads up. You're going to see the end result was that goal, but you go back to the way Jackman had played all game tonight, not only aggressive in the offensive zone, but he draws the penalty late in the game, especially when a team is trying to build momentum like LA was. It really took a lot of wind out of their sails.
Hagman's first of the year. It'll be a power play goal. 22 seconds left into an empty net. And the Flames will even the record by winning their home opener. King still battling for more. Bomeister. Backlund in the skates. Braden Schenn turns the glove save. Win of 2010, 2011, and Simmons involved with Brett Sutter. And I think cooler heads will prevail. By swiping a free club card, Ellen Lazzarato of Exxon won a Hayes Camo three-piece luggage set, courtesy of Safeway and Kraft Salad Dressing. And another giveaway goes to Donna Baldo of Winnipeg, who's also won a Hayes Camo three-piece luggage set, thanks to the empty net clincher by Nicholas Hagman, his first of the season. And Brent Sutter heads to his office with a victory.
Well, and again, that's a well-deserved victory there with the Flames shorthanded. Two men early in that first period. They've had to put a lot of different lineups on the ice at certain times. Mika Kiprusoff held them in early in this game, and then just the tenacity of the Flames took over.
Three-star selection is brought to you by Molson Canadian, made from Canada.
Well, Peter, you mentioned it, Anze Kopitar, I think he was on the ice the whole game, really could have had two or three good opportunities to score. Kiprusoff, the second star, was the reason that he didn't score because of the great saves. And then Curtis Glencross led by example. That shorthanded goal really ended up igniting this crowd here tonight.
Glencross opened the scoring with that shorthanded marker at 11:31 of the second period. Craig Conroy found the net early in the third. A goal by Dustin Brown made it exciting down the stretch before Nicholas Hagman iced it with an empty netter. RJ Broadhead back at the Sportsnet Connected Studios. Coming your way next is the Flames successful in their home opener for a second straight year. Flames lost both Hardy and Bourque early in the game to injury. A shorthanded bench able to hold off a very good Kings team. We'll have lots more coming your way in our post game, but now, here's RJ.